this is not good.
Oh. Hi, I'm Mark. I'm bald. I used to be a senior artist at Blizzard Entertainment. And now I teach art for a living. In this week's episode of my weekly series that I've been calling YouTube Art School, I'm going to show you some tricks to more easily draw different male body types. 6 to be exact. I did the female versions about a month ago, so you can check that one too. It's been pretty popular. I'm not going to be redoing the same video again, so this should still be helpful if you've seen the female version already. I guarantee you that your art will improve by at least 1000% thanks to this class. So what are we waiting for? Let's get this class started. Class is in session. Pay attention. But first, you are required by law to pay the fee to watch the video. Either one like or one sub. No cheating. Or else... Anyways, like I said, I'm going to be drawing 6 different body types that are pretty different. And I'll explain the characteristics that I think are the most important to make varied body types that still remain believable, while also being aesthetic. Well, most of them. You can think of those characteristics as sliders in an RPG game character creator that you can increase and decrease to get a pretty wide range of bodies. You might have seen other videos on body proportions or books even that categorize the different bodies as like fruits or vegetable shapes, but I hate that approach. I'm a hater because it makes no sense in the real world, at least no sense to me. I much prefer to focus on logic, so instead we'll focus on 3 simple characteristics that apply to most body types and that you can combine to get a wide range of male bods. Only 3 characteristics: proportions, fat distribution, and muscles. Much easier to remember and apply. No need to bring groceries into this. Now, I will say that you'll probably need to have good knowledge of 2 art fundamentals: construction and anatomy, to make these characteristics work and for this whole video to make more sense. I made a tutorial not long ago about male body construction, so that might help make this video easier to follow. You can find it in the top right corner of the screen or down in the description below. Oh hey, maybe you don't care. Maybe you just want to see me draw some characters, that's fine too. I recorded the video in 60 frames per second, so it should be watchable at 0.25 speeds if you want to observe the process better. Wow, that's love. I just highly recommend that you disable the audio if you do. I warned you. So let's get right into... Oh, wait, I'm already done with the base character. So this Chad here is going to be the average body that I'll base all the others on. Obviously, he's not average by real life standard. Real life isn't as aesthetic. Don't believe me? Well, here's me right here next to him. Those are my actual proportions, more or less. And look at me, I look like a kid next to Chad. It's my art though, and I have the power to make improvements, so that's why my average dude looks like that. Much better. All right, the first characteristic that I'll tackle will be the muscles. In this case, pretty simple. I'm just gonna take the base guy and make him swole, not changing anything else. The first 3 characters will just be a representation of the 3 individual characteristics. After that, we'll mix them up to see more extreme body types. Of course, for this one here, simply adding muscle is not going to change the proportions or the fat level. He's mainly going to gain bigger, more defined arms and delts, a shredded midsection, and 3 trunk legs. Very similar otherwise. To draw big muscles, there's no secret. Learn anatomy. But use references from bodybuilders. It's very useful to your overall anatomy knowledge to know what muscles like when they're more atrophied and when they're massive. It's very useful to be able to draw that range. Now, the next characteristic that we'll look at will be the proportions. In green here, I have colored what I'll usually allow myself to stretch. In yellow, that's gonna stretch, but just a little bit in comparison, and the rest would not stretch much. Well, actually, there's only the torso left, so don't mess with the torso proportions too much. It's the part of the body that will typically deform the least. Keep in mind here, I'm not bringing the fat into this conversation yet. And there's a good reason why the torso doesn't stretch much. We always have 24 vertebrae. We always have 12 ribs. And the ribs, they can't get too close to the hips or they'll touch when you bend too much. Similarly, the torso can be too long since we don't have enough vertebrae to make that work. And also, it's just easier to remember it that way. Torso, always stays the same. Keep the torso ratio pretty similar across your characters and it should work pretty well. You'll see up here though that there's a green band in between the shoulders, so the shoulder width can change a bit, especially for heroic characters that need to look wide and imposing. Still, vertically, keep the ratio the same. I'll just allow a little bit of stretching horizontally, just a little. You can also scale the whole thing up or down uniformly. There's no laws against that in particular. So, anyways, what does that look like exactly? Well, you could use the proportion characteristic to make short characters like dwarves that have more stumpy limbs, yet where the rest of the body remains similar to the average body, or make a tall, skinny character like I'm doing now. And all I'm doing here really is making the limbs longer. Taller characters will also tend to look skinnier, so you can accentuate this body type by removing some of the muscle mass too. I didn't remove much though, because you take two different people of two different heights but with the same muscle mass, and the shorter guy will always seem more swole since he's packing all of that same mass on a smaller frame. Tall guys are pretty rare in bodybuilding competitions for that reason. They need to pack on a ton of muscle to look big. Like this guy here, he wouldn't do too good, even though he shares about the same muscle mass as the average character. Also, here again to double check, same torso proportions. And well, here are his stats. This time we played with the proportions, of course, and by stretching the body, yet not adding muscles, he looks skinnier. So it's just as if he lost muscles, proportionally speaking, compared to the average. That's why the arrow is pointing down for this one. For the next body type, we'll focus on the last characteristic, the fat. Basically, I'm drawing a dad bod, as if the average character stopped going to the gym and got chubby instead, like me in the future, maybe. If you've seen the female body type video, I discussed the fat distribution for the female body, and well, guess what? It's not the same for males. It's a lot simpler to remember for male characters, I think. The fat will primarily just be distributed around the gut and the glutes. Of course, as you get morbidly obese, it'll just spread everywhere, but still, primarily around those two areas. And that's a generalization. Just like most of this video, everybody's different. Some guys will carry fat more like a woman would, just like some women will have a fat distribution that might be more typical for men. I'm just focusing on what is easier to categorize with these simple characteristics. Ain't nobody got time to cover all body types. But yeah, there he is, future Mark, so hot. If we look at the stats here again, more fat and well, just like the tall guy, less muscle. Muscles are like fat burning factories, so it's more uncommon to see muscular and fat men. Usually if the character is fat, it would imply that they're not in shape, just like this typical dad bod. And by the way, here's the male fat distribution like I was talking about. Pretty easy to remember. Big butt, bigger gut. Now that we have an example for all those individual characteristics, what happens when we push them a bit? The next character's stats will increase all across the board, with a special focus on the fat to create something that might look more like a sumo wrestler. Tall, imposing, super fat, but also very strong. Can still look pretty cool. Look at this guy. He's just staring you down before sitting on your face. The last body type will be extreme, but almost in the opposite direction. This time I'm focusing on pushing the proportions even more to create a super imposing tall character, like a man god, not adding any fat whatsoever and doubling down on the muscle mass to make him look big, even though he's tall. What I like about this approach to drawing body types is that as long as you have a solid, average character, you can really get a lot of variety, and the little bit of logic behind their characteristics helps give us a clearer direction. I say us, but I mean me. It helps me, but maybe it'll help you too. In any case, there's our lineup. Man, that last bro is like 10 heads tall. Not bad. Look at me next to him. I'm like his newborn child. Whee! And we can see all the stats for the body types now. There's lots of combinations that we haven't seen yet. You do it. Oh, and just to double check the proportions again before we wrap this up. Torso ratio stays similar here as well as across the board. See? Anyways, that's it for this week's class. By the way, want my sketching brush, bro? You can download it for free, along with a bunch of my other main brushes. Click the link in the top right corner of the screen here, or down below. Experts all agree, it's the best line art brush to ever exist, for real. Also, if you happen to use the brushes, or if you get working on some cool body types, tag me on social media, Instagram and Twitter. I often try to repost stories when I'm tagged and retweet on Twitter whenever I have some free time. I love to see what you create too, so share away. Don't be stingy. I can't give you feedback on your art though. Everybody asks. There's just not enough time in the day. That's for my students only. If you want to become my student though, you can. Check the link to my complete college equivalent art education in the video description. It's a 2-year program from home, and there's nothing like it. The value is crazy, if I dare say so myself. There is a self-learned program that's cheaper and a mentorship version that comes with feedback for a full year. I recommend the program to every artist from complete beginners to professionals. And I have a discount going until the end of the month for the self-learned version. Use the promo code ARTSCHOOL in one word for a big discount on the program. And that's it for this week. I'll see you guys next Friday.